I don't even know why you closed it. So, on our way into the first set, I got my son with me today. Isaac, say hi. Oh, he just fell. He just fell. Oh yeah, first set, the one that somebody else helped me check once before. Let's see here. Let's see if we got anything. Whoa, snow's a little rotten. It's been 40 degrees the last couple days. Cold at night, warm during the day. Oh, look, my pocket knife. See it right there? Let's find out. Some air bubbles. That may or may not be a good thing. Let's see. See a set off snare. I see twisted up cable. Oh, what do I got here? I got an extra stick again. Some twisted up snares. What the heck? Looks like I caught a stick again. Oh, I got a beaver. I got a beaver. Little guy. There's one. Grab my pocket knife that fell out last time I was here. And there's one. Oh, pretty simple little set there. Let's go check the next set. See if I can do this without getting wet. Don't get too close to me.
Yep.
This ice isn't super thick. All right. And then the conibear set here. Over here at the bank den. That trap still isn't tripped. Oh. No sense in pulling that one out. Just leave it right there. Pull that 330 and we'll pull that beaver out of the snare and reset it. Be on our way. Oh. Careful, that's open water there too. So, we reset the snare pole down there. Got us a little beaver, 1 year old. He's gonna carry it to the truck. I'll take a better look at it up there. Now it's my turn to fall through the snow. Right there, Isaac, stop, rub it in the snow and dry it off. Get as much of the water out of it as you can. There you go. Oh, and that actually, believe it or not, dries the fur off. So we lost 11 minutes of footage putting the boy to work. This is set number 5 on this pond. We've managed to snare a stick that we had real tight, so there was a beaver attached to the stick when it got caught. This was that run. I tripped the trap while I was chipping it out of the ice. I made it wider, trying to find the other end, and it's grounded over on this side. It's grounded ice, so the run is right there. So we're gonna reset this one. There's got to be another run coming out of that lodge, or those beavers haven't come out for 3 days. So we shall see. Reset the run and be on our way. And nothing in there. Let me go ahead and drop that one back down, Isaac. So, yep. Oh yeah, I'm thinking probably over here we'll shovel it out and put in another baited set. We got 3 more baited sets there in the sled ready to go. Alright, see ya after we get everything set. Well, pulled that one, no beaver. Set that one over there. I pulled that trap. I can't get it to set deep enough in the run to where it's not going to freeze in. That's why it tripped the last time. I cut the run another 18 inches or so bigger, and I just can't get it. It's not going to be deep enough. So that one will have to wait until ice is out. But anyway, I lost 11 minutes of footage over there chipping all that other stuff out. Snared another stick, probably pissed off the beaver. The snare was sucked tight on the stick, so the beaver had a hold of it. Yeah, we're out of here. We ended up with 2 beaver on the day. I'll show you the other one when we get up there to the truck. Now there's both beavers that were caught today. There's that one that you've seen. This one, that's in the 11 and a half minutes of lost footage. But both of them caught in snares. This one's probably going to be 50 pounds. And that one was last year's. So it's getting dark. Wind's picking up. The boy, he's getting cold. We got a couple more stops to make, potentially setting more. We'll see. But wind is starting to pick up here in the valley, and it's about 9 o'clock at night, 8, 9 o'clock at night. So the midnight sun's coming out. So, check number 4 of this set. Let's see how we're doing. Trying to walk out here without snowshoes today. Oh, that's not working so hot for me. Should have wore the snowshoes. Bare minimum, the gauntlets. Oh, that's my buddy Josh that's up there with us. Oh. You can see where I just punched through the snow. Let's see what we got going on here. I'll get back to you in a minute. Let's try this again. My dumbass forgot everything at the Suburban. I got in such a hurry, I just ran out there, didn't bring the chipping bar, the sled, nothing. So I'm gonna go back out there. This time I'm wearing my snowshoes so I don't punch holes anymore than I already have. And I'm bringing the chipping bar and the sled. Let's see if I can get out there without falling in.
Prepared this time?
Prepared this time.
Oh, you
shit. See if we got a beaver in this one. Super thin, that's a good sign. Today, it's about 25, 26 degrees. 15 mile an hour constant wind and gusting to up over 30, so. That one snare messed up that I can see right now. I don't know if there's anything in it. Don't. Nope. Don't look like nothing there this time. Pull the snares back tight. Here, open them back up and get this stuck back in there. I don't know why this one was closed. That's that messed up snare that I caught that other beaver in. Takes care of that. Sprung. That one is not sprung at all. Let's see if I can reposition it. You'd think. Going on. This is the fourth check here. Maybe they got another run built around it. Oh, did I fall? That one. Ugh. Put a blocking off stick here. There we go. There we go. Off to the next. Oh, I brought it with me. I'm gonna set it. We're right here. Got that snare pole there. I'm gonna drop a baited 330 in right here. I already got it pre-made. I just gotta set it out. And you can see over there where the snow collapsed on the lodge. I might go, I got another 330 with me. I might go see if that's settable. I know last fall in this pond, I counted about 17 beaver on this slough. Goes from about a quarter mile this way, wraps down through here, down and around. It was about another 3 miles back in there. But they got it dammed off there, and a lodge here, and another unobtainium lodge back there until we can put the canoe in. But yeah, I'm gonna drop that baited 330 in right here. See if I can't produce a beaver. Thank you, Josh. Oh, another belial. Things that make you go, apparently. There we go. Now I'll get it set. See that and then come through. There we go. There's that one. Let's snowshoot around and see if I can't go peek and see what happened over there. Oh, that's where the snow collapsed. There's nowhere near getting down there safely. And I'm not one for Russian roulette. I know that water is about 12 feet deep. So, not going to set that run. There's no safe way to get over there. Not to mention I got two baited sets right there. And they're traveling through there. So, we'll move on to the next. Well, bebopping down the highway here. I pulled 6 beaver off this spot last year. And haven't really been in a hurry to set it this year because I pulled so many off of it last year. And it's just a small little slough with a big dam and with a big house on it.
A dam back in there too last year.
And I pulled 2 50-ish pound beavers. I don't weigh my beavers, but 2 of them that were about 50 pounds. There were 3X beavers, 2 3X beavers, 2 1X beavers, and then 2 smaller ones I pulled out of here last year. I pulled 5 at one time, so I pulled everything off of it. But anyways, you can see where the beavers are coming up out of the ice. So I think I'm going to set this cross over here. But I want to verify it's beaver and not otter. Because our otter season is over with already. It ended about 10 days ago. Oh yeah. That be beaver. That be beaver. Oh. There's another spot right over here where they're popping up. I'm gonna set. I got one extra conibear with me right now. You can see one of my poles from last year, because that's one of the bank dens. But you don't need to watch me snowshoe over there, but I'll turn back on once I get over there. Oh guys, I got a conundrum here. That's the run. I can't legally set this run. Here in Alaska, after, April 15th, I wanna say, and today's the 23rd, all of our traps have to be 100% submerged. Water's not deep enough to set that run. And everything's obviously way too wide out here to even attempt it. So when I come back out next time, looks like I'm bringing some footholds with me, so he'll get a pass this time. He will get a pass. And this ice, I know from last year, this little creek, it's not much, but it's over 10 feet deep right out here. So I'm gonna get off of it. There's one of my beaver sticks from last year, one of my anchor sticks. I'll be back. Because there's 6 bank dens between... Oh, there's 6 bank dens between where I'm standing and 100 feet that way. So, I'll be back. There's that much activity. There's still several more right here. So after some investigation there. I'm gonna have to bring out some number fours. I use Duke number four for my beaver footholds. The water just isn't deep enough. So, all right, on to the next spot. There we go. The rotten ice is growing. One day I'll ride that down. One day. You really start to see that feed pile now. We had a bunch of 40 and 50 degree weather since the last time I was here. Let's chip this out and see if we can't find one. There we go. That'll help. That'll help when I chip the right spot. Sorry, checking the camera. Oh, this one has not been touched. All right, on to the next. So last week, snared a big beaver in here. Boom. 3x super blanket squared out 73 inches. I put it on the board. So this one shipped out. Find out. I had the same luck. No ice. Zero ice on the back side of that pole. Doesn't feel like there's anything there. Nothing there. So, I reset this. Control throwing the slush out of the way. try again. Yeah, you should see the little feed pile there. Since I left my snowshoe, or since I left my shovel at the house. It didn't take long for that snare to freeze. There we go. That one'll slide. Set for a minute, refreeze into spot, and I'll come back and set that one back in there. Let's check this one here. That is starting to look ugly. Lower that one right back down and go check this other one. That's right, here's that other one, but I want to look and see. Yeah. Nope. I've been noticing some of the lodges that are active. We've got the beavers coming out of them now, so I want to stop and look at that one. Curious, I'm not cleaning the snow out of most of these because that one's not set off either. We're supposed to get down around zero, then warm up to 50, So I want that to freeze. I don't want it to freeze too hard, but then again, I want it to stay frozen. So although it should be frozen in place now, courtesy of Mother Nature. Dip them in. There we go. Set it that way. Two more left to check. All the way down yonder. Josh got cold, he put on my other coat. Windy, drifted in. Had two sets here. I had to pull that one last week to get in the water. I couldn't get it set right in the water where it was completely buried. So, ship this one out. That doesn't feel like. That one feels empty too. Yeah, that one's empty. One more, right over here. Yeah, it's almost like we got snow since Wednesday. Blowing snow, that is. We've had 30 mile an hour the last 2 days. Plus we got about an inch of snow last night. So the hole all chipped out. Doesn't feel like there's anything there. That one's not tripped either. Oh, there's that. Well, check number four was a complete strikeout. Anyway. On to the next one. See you guys next time. Alright guys. So I've been having technical difficulties today. We ran the line backwards. I pulled the sets that are on the very last pond. The ice is just way too rotten. It's not safe going out on anymore. But this one here, I got everything set where I can get to it without going out on the ice. I already come out, chipped everything out. See where the beavers are coming up and out over there. I set that 330 off that stick there last week. I got the snare pole right there. I got a 330 there. I just added a couple more blocking off sticks to that one. There was nothing in it. I chipped out the snare pole. There was nothing in it. But this is why I use Belial conibears. Right here. This is a rear foot catch in a 330. I'm not even really sure how, but I'll take it. Not a very big guy, but it's a beaver nonetheless. There it is. And it pulled out. Pulled out, get it reset. It dropped back down in there. So, not a very big beaver, but a beaver nonetheless. So, reset this. This all resituated. Tucked up in there. Reset, pick that up, get those safeties off. I really like the way the Belial does their 330s. Right there, and they're swimming by here. I've caught one here now, and I've caught one right there, and one right there now, so yeah. It works. Get him up here off the log, dried out, rub him in the snow. It's almost 60 degrees out. We got a couple days where beaver trapping is gonna be real slow because of the ice situation, but oh, little guy. Another one for the tannery. All right. Hey guys, so this is the end of the video. We're gonna be moving into a lot more foothold trapping, conibear trapping for beavers on the next video. As you can see, the ice is pretty much gone. I was gonna trim out a bunch of the ice chipping, but I decided I want everybody to know what it's like to really trap beaver under the ice. It's not all fun and games. It's a lot of work. A lot of preseason and postseason work goes into it. I had 8 sets, 2 weeks, 2 ponds. I pulled 6 beaver. Mosquitoes are starting to show up too. So anyway, I'll see you all on the next video. It'll be coming out in the next couple days. I don't think it's going to be as long as this one is. We got some foothold catches, some snared beaver catches that I set on
beaver runs where I snared them, bank dens, things of that nature. Anyway, see you on the next one.